Hang on.
And we're live.
Hang on.
When it's live on the corner, I think it's live.
Oh, all right. I'll leave you to it then.
Hello. I think we're live. Good afternoon, everyone. Beautiful people. My name is Billy Boy, and I am here to do some makeup before the show. Because tonight we have a wonderful show. We have Quarantine Cabaret, Circus at Home version by SANCA. It's a beautiful show. It's actually a collection of little acts that people made at home with the skills they learned during the quarantine. Why the name Quarantine Cabaret? So I'm gonna do my face. As you can see, I already started. I'm a little pink on the cheeks. I started with the foundation, as you can see. I wanted to start a little early last time for Circus at Home with a twist. I took about an hour and a half to do the makeup, and I had to rush at the end a little bit. So this time I decided to start early and really take my time and be able to show you every single step I do for my eye, because, you know, that's where the magic happens. And finally, this is not vodka, this is water, I promise. And I have a straw because I'm gonna put some lipstick on later. And I need to drink water. Okay, so let's get started. Guys, I'm gonna bring you a little closer to me, because, you know, in this time of quarantine, every time we can get close to each other, like now, we do. Okay, let's get started with some. I'm gonna start actually with my eyebrow. I'm gonna define my eyebrow and then we're gonna get into the eye. And for the eyebrow, Benefit Cosmetic. I'm not here to sell anything, but I really like Benefit Cosmetic, just saying. Why do I like Benefit Cosmetic? Because when it comes to eyebrow, they are the best, actually. Bronzer as well. I mean, they're the best for a lot of things. But my eyebrow, there is only Benefit that touches it. So I'm using actually kind of a cream right now to really bring some color inside my eyebrow, redefine its perfect shape. I got my eyebrows waxed today. Yeah, my partner waxed my eyebrow. It was really nice. It had been a while, so there was quite a bit of work to do, but we did it. And now I have a nice eyebrow to work with. I'm super happy about it. Oh yeah, by the way, last time I actually blocked my eyebrow with some glue and then I draw a new one, a fake one on top. This time, because my eyebrow was really well done by my partner, I decided to keep it and actually use my own eyebrow for the makeup. Just a different technique, just a different way of going into the makeup and into the character, which is actually really cool. I do like to play with Billy Boy's makeup. It's not always the same. There is a few things that are standard to his character, and then there is always that little playful where I like to discover new ways of using certain products, or sometimes I just pick up something completely new and I just make it work. I like to keep it playful and experimental. Cup. I like that shape. Yeah, I like that. Dun, dun, dun. And then I have a little powder to actually fix it. Because since it's a little greasy, I really want to make sure to put some powder in it to make sure that it stays where it's supposed to and it doesn't drag anywhere. And I like it. It's a little darker than my hair. So it has a nice little tone to it. Then I'm gonna come here at the beginning. It's a little lighter than the rest of the eyebrow. I like to play with different colors. Dude, it's pretty. Not me pretty, just the eyebrow. By the way, if you want, you can do the makeup with me. Because, you know, it's always a good reason to put some makeup on. Now that we're not going out of our houses, you know, putting some makeup on just to stay home, why not? I never do that. Beautiful. Up. Wonderful. Yes. I think I'm just gonna take it a little. Good. Goody good. Okay. I'm gonna grab our colors. I started using a super nice product. Again, by Benefits. And I love it because it's helping to keep the eyeshadow on my eyelid and all over because I literally put it anywhere. But it's an awesome product. It's by Benefit as well. And again, like, I'm not sure if I should see the company of the product I'm using, but I'm just saying it. It's pretty nice. It's from Benefit, and I love it. And it's called Stay, Don't Stay, Don't Spray. So it really helps the eyeshadow to stay where you put it, and also it kind of like intensifies the pigment of it. So I really, really like that product. And also, it helps, and that's like, just because I put so much foundation on, but it also kind of like help with the little imperfection of the foundation wherever I'm in to the makeup at that time. So I really love it. And you're going to see it's really, really nice. Boom. And right now I'm using it just underneath my eyebrow to kind of clean it and really make like a nice, nice line. A nice contrast between where I want my light to be and where I want my eyebrow to be. It's super nice because it fixes everything. It fixes all the little imperfection that you may have in your foundation. Love it.
Love.
As you can see, I put it on the side of my hand. I don't like to use the brushes inside the product. I like to be able to wash my brushes. So I cleaned the edge of my eyebrow, and now I'm gonna put some eyeshadow in there. And it's one of my favorite ones. It's from MAC. It's a light shine. And it's pretty incredible. It picks up the light exactly the way it needs to, but not too much that it brings more attention into your arch than into your eye. I love that. Boom. Beautiful. We're gonna keep that with the stay don't spray because we're gonna get into the eye now. Oh. Boom, boom, boom. Beautiful. This one. Gonna grab my other little palette of color. It's Benefit again. I'm sorry. And I'm going to create my crease. So technically here, I'm recreating a crease a little higher than mine, again, to accentuate my eye, to make my eye look bigger and more stretched to the outside. And I'm really, really liking that color. Pretty intense. Don't worry, it's gonna come down. But I like to start with the dark and then create my blends. This one is like a little shine brown. I like to add to it. Again, the first one didn't have any shine, so I like to add that one on top, just again, to pick up a little bit of light. And then now I'm blending all the two together with a lighter, like a little skin tone, just to create the transition between the dark and the light of the arch. Up. Just a little there. Boom. I like that. It's a little dramatic. And you know, it needs some drama. Ba, ba, ba. Oh, you guys are saying that I'm already looking fabulous. So stop it. You're flattering me. Keep coming, keep coming. I love that. There is never enough flattery. But thank you. I started early. I really wanted to get the foundation done and look, I'm a little pinkish. Okay. Let's keep going. Up. And I really like that little blender. So now I'm bringing back my Stay Don't Spray, because I'm going to fix the inside of my eyelid. You see now there is some color everywhere. It's not neat, it's not clean, it's not well defined. So now I'm gonna technically cover all those imperfections, create an entire eyelid out of that cream, and then I'm gonna be able to work on top of it. And no, I did not create this technique. I actually watched quite a few videos of amazing queens from RuPaul's Drag Race. And I have to admit, I spent quite a bit of time watching those videos. I love it. And they're on YouTube and they're all fabulous. And their makeups are flawless. And so I learned a lot by watching other queens doing their work. And I'm not saying that I'm copying, but I mean, you have to learn somewhere, so. And makeup is always evolving. I mean, when I was a drag in Montreal, 15 years ago, a little more than that, but actually I'm not gonna say how many years, because then you're gonna start doing some math. You're gonna realize I'm not as young as I look in makeup. So, you know, like 2 years ago, when I was in Montreal, I was a young queen and makeup was very different than it is today. It's always improving. And that's one of the reasons I like makeup so much. It's because it's always, always changing, always new product, always new techniques. And it's awesome. It's awesome. It's an ever-changing world. And you cannot get bored. Always something to learn. And if you like to learn, well, it's the right business for you. I'm liking this. I'm gonna take a chance here. And I'm gonna use a product that I really like. I've been using for years, but not with this new technique. So it's kind of an experiment here again. Look at that shine. It's a nice little white powder with incredible shine in it. And I'm really liking that combination of the Stay Don't Spray, because it's really keeping the product where it needs to be. And I have the feeling that I'm also able to use less product with a better finish than when I use it by itself directly. I was about to say my skin, but there is no product touching my skin right now with the layers of foundation I have on. So there is way too much foundation on my face. I can tell you the eyeshadow is not touching my eye. Beautiful. I'm really liking that result. What do you think? It's nice. It's so shiny. Like, you're not going to be able to look at me anymore. It's like, oh, Billy Boy, you're too shiny. You're blinding me. Ooh. You know, when I do, usually when I get ready with other people, we can talk and we can laugh and make jokes. Now I just laugh at my own jokes and it's not pathetic at all. It's fine. Everything's fine. I'm Melanie Queen in her living room. Dining room, it's a combo. Getting ready by herself. Making jokes for herself. And for you. Because I love you. No, I'm not gonna sing. I promise. You do not want me to sing. Just so you know. If there is only one talent that I don't have, it's singing. I mean, it's been raining in Seattle and you don't want more rain. So do not make me sing. Okay, I think this looks very nice. Very, very nice. I like it. I'm gonna keep it just in case I need a little touch up later, but it has a beautiful effect right now. I want to bring a little bit of the bronze. So now what I'm gonna do, I have my crease that I'm gonna redefine again later. I'm gonna bring some black in there. But now that I have that beautiful white eyeshadow, I need to bring that corner a little more in and create some kind of a blend. And I think a nice little bronze could do a nice job at doing just that. So I'm gonna take a little brush. Oh, baby brush. And let's get started. So to do that, I really want to be dedicated and cautious about where I put the color and where I put the pigment. So not only I'm using a small brush, but I'm also kind of like wiping a little bit of the excess that I have on the brush before I touch my eye with it. Because I really want to be careful on how much pigment I'm putting on my eye right now. So you know what, I think it's gonna be a nice under eye as well. I think it's gonna do an incredible job. Let's take it underneath as well. Let's see how that goes. Oh yeah. A nice little finish. Oh, if there is a background noise, don't worry about it. It's my laundry. Because, you know, I'm kind of in charge in this house. And I do laundry, and well, laundry doesn't do itself. I have to do it, and it's drying right now. And so I think that's what the noise you can hear. And that's why I like to use individual brushes for each color, because I can always use, like for example, I just use the brush I kept using for the for my light. I can always go back and whoop, do a little correct and go back into what I was doing. It's little, it's discreet, but it gives that intensity. I'm really happy with it right now. Beautiful. Oh! See, it's something I've never done before, but it's worth trying sometimes. And I'm gonna add just a little line of purple, just right here. It's like a deep purple, this one right here. Just because it helps. I don't have a very big eyelash on the bottom or on the top actually. And doing a little line like that is going to help my eyelash to kind of pop a little bit and create some kind of a more intense line of eyelash. And I discovered that recently and I'm really liking the effect. So I keep doing it. It's very little, just at the bottom of the eyelash. I'm not blending it, I'm not stretching it. It's really just there, just to intensify the bottom of my eye. Beautiful. Okay. I like that so far. I'm really liking the effect. Okay, now. Now it's time for, if you've been watching me do my makeup, you know what's coming next. Black eyeliner, liquid black eyeliner. And I'm super excited because I just changed. I used to use a product by Dior and loved it. Loved everything about it. Wanted to try something different. And so now I started working with the eyeliner by Benefit Cosmetic. And I'm, first of all, come on, it's adorable. And I'm really liking it. I love the tip. I think it's really well done. And it works really well. Like it does the same job. And yep, so try it. So now we're going to do our little line of black eyeliner. Sorry, I have so we're going to do the line on the bottom. I'm actually going to bring it a little bit to define the my new crease, and then I'm going to take it a little bit on the bottom in the corner and then create my little tip cat eye in the inner eye. So I'm gonna start with the crease. Sorry, I'm being super quiet. I'm so focused. I mean, I love using it, but you know, it's black liquid eyeliner. You have to be precise in what you do. So sorry if I'm quiet. I'm taking my time and I'm doing it carefully. You know what? I'm gonna try to bring my mirror a little higher that you can see what I'm doing. And that's better for you, but that shaky mirror in my hand. And it's not too dramatic. If it's not perfect, I'm gonna use a little bit of black powder, first of all, to fix it, because it's liquid, and also to just like blend it with the rest of the crease. Beautiful. I'm gonna blend it right away. Hydration. Also, I didn't tell you that, but you know, it's just between you and I. When I was doing my foundation, I use a fix, a neutral set powder. And somehow, as I'm doing it, and I put a lot of it, my nose started to tickle. And in my mind, I was like, oh yeah, I just like blow my nose and it's gonna be fine. And I actually inhaled. So I inhaled a lot of set powder and I coughed for 15 minutes. So if I cough tonight, I'm not sick. It's just powder. From the chat, you are captivating. I tried to walk away from my computer and find myself immediately turning around. Oh, that's the magic of Billy, dear. Oh, I'm coming back because of your words. Oh, I'm working on my English, I promise. I'm freshly imported from France. So my English is still, but it's probably why you're coming with, like, what did he say? You're making me smile. Oh, you guys are making me smile too. I'm so happy we're doing this together. And thank you for being here. Thank you, because it's good to know that you guys are on the other side. Again, like, I'm alone in my house right now doing that. And usually I'm with 15 other queens and having fun. And now I'm just having fun with you guys. So as you can see, I'm adding some black on top of the line I created with liquid. And it's nice because it's setting it and it's a good product. I mean, it dries super fast. It's not gonna go anywhere, but I like to give it a little bit of that matte texture to my black. And when you, at least for that line, for that crease, and I like to go over it with some black powder. And also it helps if I did a little bit of a mistake with my blank liner. It's like, oop, a little bit of powder, poof. It's no longer there. Oh, so we have a nice little crease right there. Now, what do I need to do? I need to do my actual eyeliner. I'm gonna pull out and then I'm gonna come in and bring some black eyeshadow in it. I'm gonna bring some black eyeliner in it and I'm gonna do that cat eye. So I'm gonna start I'm not going to be able to hold the mirror at the same time. You know what? Let's try to find something I can put underneath for you to keep seeing me. Give me 1 second. Okay, if I work from him, I think you're gonna see me a little better and it's gonna help. Oh yeah, that's a nice angle. I think we're going in the right direction, my friends. Boom. So I always like look at different makeup and different queens and different like what their technique is, and literally like each queen have their own way of doing their little eye outside like that. There is no right way, there is just your way of doing it, and that's another aspect of makeup that I like. There is techniques that are important to know and that to work within, but ultimately your face is your face. What works on your face might not work on someone else's face. And when I do my own makeup versus when I paint someone else, it's very different, and it's so fascinating that something that I do on me and right away I look at it, I'm like, yes, I'm in character. And then I do it on someone else and I'm like, that doesn't work with your face. So it's kind of interesting when you do someone else's makeup to really find what makes them turn into their own character and help them discover that is really cool. And it can take time. It really takes to experiment with your makeup and have fun with it as much as you can. Oh yeah, that's cute. And also, I'm gonna share something, just between you and I. Age has a huge impact on how your makeup behaves on your head. I'm doing my line, and I can tell you that 10 years ago, my eyelid behaved completely differently. It didn't stretch that much. It didn't wrinkle as much. And you know what? That's okay. Yeah, I think that's a nice angle. Yeah, beautiful. That makes me very happy right now. Gonna fix my corner. So as you can see, I have up. Okay, have my nice black line. It's pulling on the outside exactly the way I want it. And then I'm joining my arch with that line as well. It's not done, it's not finished. We're gonna add some powder to it. Personally, I like to connect the two. I've seen queens leaving them separate and actually bring some light in between. It's really pretty on some queens. I personally, it doesn't work on me. My eye, it just looks weird. It looks disconnected. It looks like I just have a line, but it doesn't look like a crease when I keep them separate on my face. So that's all. And that was the dryer. I told you I was doing some chores at the same time. Queens are people too. We do our own laundry. We go to the bathroom. We are people. We are regular people. We're fabulous, but we're regular people. Okay, now I'm going to bring it underneath. And I don't want too much, but I like a dark under eye, so. Yeah, look at that. So I bring it just little bit after the middle of my eye. I'm gonna stop it there, and then I'm gonna start it again in the corner. I'm gonna wait a little bit. My eye is a little watery, so I'm gonna take the time to actually take care of this right here and start blending it and having fun with that. So here's my purple. Oh, my black is right here. So I'm going back with my little brush and my black eyeshadow. And I'm gonna start bringing some color in right here. Beautiful. And you remember the purple I was using earlier? I think I'm gonna bring that in a little bit, just for fun. Which one am I gonna use? This one. No, I'm gonna use this one. So again, like I'm tapping a little bit my brush. I want to bring a little bit of pigment at a time. Yeah. And I'm going to bring the next color, which is that purple right here. I haven't used that one much. I bought it because I thought it was so pretty in the store. And then I kind of like never used it. And I think 2 days that I. And it's very delicate pigment. I kind of like it very much. It has a little shiny time. Yeah. Look at that. Fabuloso. And now my black in the corner is everywhere. I've been crying. Crying. So what do? Stay, don't spray, because it fixes everything. And where are you? Right here. And I'm taking my white back, the color I had working in this. Perfect. Like it didn't happen. I tell you, that product, Stay Don't Spray, is awesome. It fixes everything. Boom. Oh, very nice. Now it's time for the black corner. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of black eyeliner. I promise, it's awesome. And for it to not go anywhere, what do? I powder it. I powder it. Gently this time, very gently. You don't want to smear that line. You just want to fix it there. Like that it doesn't go anywhere. Boom. Ooh, I like it. Just gonna fix it just a tiny bit. Just a tiny bit. And this is why I do my makeup super early. Because then I can really take my time. Beautiful. Oh, I'm liking it. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna bring a little bit of my black again in here. So the way I said earlier, that line for the crease, I like to smear it a little bit with black powder. That eyeliner here, no, I want it clean and crisp. Look at this.
Oh, it's very nice. It's very nice, darling. Love it. Love it. I realized that my corner over there could use a little bit of, just a little bit of blending. Good. Just a little bit of blending. You see? Just a little bit. Okay. Let's take care of those eyelash. Because we have, oh, we have 35 minutes. Perfect. Up. No, I'm not about to cut all my eyelash at one. That's an eyelash curler for the people that didn't know. It helps me curl my eyelash. Because I told you earlier, my eyelash had tiny babies. So they need a little bit of assistance to curl correctly. Up. Mascara. So I first put a maximizer on. Again, as I said, my eyelash are so tiny that I want to give them a little bit of help. And a nice maximizer does that job. Up. No, I'm not going to put it in. Up. Now, I'm going to put some mascara. And I want mascara really all the way from the bottom to the top. All of it. And I like to kind of like spread my hand. My eyelash. I mean, you're not gonna see them when I put the fake eyelashes on, but I don't know. Maybe it's just me. I just like to spread it. That's very nice. Up. Where is right here? I have my black pen. I'm gonna do my waterline. And as I was explaining last time, I always want to pull my my eyelid down. And then I realized that I have a fingerprint in my foundation. So I try to remember not to pull it and just like run my pen onto my eye, which is not the easiest, to be very honest. I love a little bit of home. And I like to do the top waterline as well. Not especially all the way. Oh, thank you very much, Christine. It's shimmery because I actually use a little shimmer. I have to admit, I'll show you which one in a second. own.
So I'm actually using this, and I'm actually going to add more shimmer later, but it's called Cookie by Benefit Cosmetic. It's this one right here. And I put it just here on the cheek and here in the center. And I'm pretty sure the sequins behind me accentuate all that, but that beautiful powder does that shiny and bright effect for sure. Okay, it is time for fake eyelashes, or actually eyelash, because I only put one. Let's grab our eyelash glue. Boom. And I know I showed you guys last time, but I'm gonna show again how I like to do my glue on my eyelash. I take my eyelash right here. It's a 301. A lot of queens actually use that one. I actually take the glue with the tip end of my brush and I run it along the edge of my eyelash. I don't take the tube directly to the eyelash because, well, I'm a little messy. And so if I do that, I'm gonna glue the entire fake eyelash to itself. So up, I can spread it nice and easy. And like any fake eyelashes and any glue, you wanna give it a little bit of time to dry, to get a little tacky before to put it on. So I really like that makeup. Kind of happy with it today. Boom. Let's put it on. Or at least try to put it on. Sometimes it takes me more than one try, you know. Okay, that's a nice angle actually. Beautiful. I'm gonna leave it there for a little bit. I'm gonna let it really anchor itself in my makeup and in my eyeliner, and then I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna put some mascara on it to kind of like merge my eyelashes with the fake eyelashes to give one big effect. Very nice. Oh, it's pretty. Perfect. What do you think? I think my favorite is when I start using it.
gonna start flying. Actually, you should probably put another one on the other side. It's like one wing is not gonna be enough. You're gonna need two wings if you wanna fly. For the new arrival, the people that just checking in, this is water. I'm not saying you don't know what you're talking about. I'm just saying I prefer you to know it's water. It's not vodka. And I use a straw, I use a straw because I'm fancy. But I also use a straw because I'm gonna have some lipstick on later. And it's not pretty. I drink a glass of water with my makeup. Also, I realize the bottom of the glass works a little bit like how do you call that in English? A magnifying glass. And then you can see the back of my throat, like, boom, right there. Or my teeth, right there. If I tilt the glass a little too far. So it's not a teeth day, it's an eye day. Okay, let's bring that mascara on. And so I'm not taking it all the way. It's really just to merge my eyelash with the fake eyelash. It's not, I'm not like, the makeup does that. Oh, it's pretty, I like it. I like it. Boom. Should I or should I not? Do I have the time? Yes, I do have the time. I want to fix the inside of my eye a little bit. And I'd like to add a little bit, just a little bit of black in the corner, just to make it a little more tense. I'm not gonna use the liquid eyeliner. I'm actually gonna use powder and go very gently and very delicately. Leslie is asking me to tell a joke. I think I'm gonna have to make a research for that. I'm not especially, I like to believe that I'm a funny character. I don't know, I never went to see myself in show, but usually people laugh. The question is, are they laughing with me or are they laughing at me? I always made a point to never ask because I'm not sure I'm ready to hear the answer. But I'm not especially like a joke kind of character, but let me think about it. Or maybe I can find something online. Yeah, I like that. I don't know. You're really putting me on the spot, Leslie. Oh, I don't know jokes. Can someone actually in the chat send me a joke? I'll read it and I'll do a funny voice if you you have to help me. I think right now I'm the joke. to not have a joke to tell you. Wow, I don't have a joke. I didn't even prepare for that. A good joke. Not a dad joke. By the way, a dad joke is not a thing in French. Like, it's very American to say that. Like, I could say, oh, it's in black, the papa, mais, like, it doesn't have any meaning to say that in French. A joke. Oh, you're really putting me on the spot. No, I want to hide. I'm going to hide behind my makeup. Sorry, I'm just adding a little bit of black andouille because I realized that it could really intensify. Yeah, I actually like that very much. Boom. I think we're almost done with the eye. I'm going to show you another product that I use that is awesome. I really, really love for to create some more lights. Okay, so Missy is sending a job. I'm not sure I get it. Oh, okay. I'm actually gonna say it. It's a funny one, and also because it talks about cats, and I like cats. So I'm not a cat lady, but I really like cats, and I really like my cat. So the joke is, what do you call a pile of kittens? No one. A meowton. A meowton. I love it. A meowton. It took me a little bit because, you know, reading it is not the same as hearing it. But it's really funny. And it talks about cats. And I love cats. I really love cats. I'm very lucky I have a cat. He's a little over 1 year old. His name is Prince Smooches Clabo. He's a Maine Coon. He's gorgeous. He has a temper, like his mother. But he's pretty awesome. Do you want to see a picture? I am going to show you a picture of my cat. Oh, and now I realize that my partner is actually watching the show right now and sent me some jokes. And the joke is, I don't trust stairs. They're always up to something. And oh, that's a funny one. You're cute. Oh, and by the way, I love you very much. And thank you. I really do like the makeup too. So the product I want to talk to you about is Hiding by Benefit. It's awesome. I had it in my makeup case, didn't use it. And one day I tried it and I was like, what have I been waiting? It's awesome. Look, you can't see, there's too much light. But I take just a little bit of it, I put it on the brush, and look at that light. It's really catching everything right here. Look at this. Oh, I'm loving this product. And it's liquid, but you just tap it like that. And it just blends so nicely and so easily. I have to be careful, to be honest, on how much I'm putting on, because it's so easy to get a little crazy with that product, to be honest. Because you're like, oh my God, it's so beautiful, it's shiny. And then you're like, oh, I've put too much. But not this time. I promise. This time I'm staying away from putting too much on. Or at least I'll try. That's so funny. I didn't know he would be watching. Oh, that's so cute. Oh, Missy is sending me another joke. What does a chameleon have that doesn't change color? Huh. What does the chameleon have that doesn't change color? I have no idea, I'm saying. You're gonna have to send me the answer to that one. Okay. Now that we have our light, we have our eye, we have our contour. Well, we need our lips because, you know, right now it's a little too skin tone for me. I need a little more. So, I'm gonna add. Fixing the foundation, I'm gonna bring a little bit of powder. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that out loud. No, no, no. There is kids watching. Oh, that was a fun one though. Okay, back to the lips. I'm gonna do a nice little contour of my lips. I like to start with a neutral tone, so that's why I put some more foundation on. It's the same color as the rest of my base foundation. I like to come to a neutral plane. Mouth, and then I'm gonna do a contour, and then I'm gonna start filling in. So let's start. I'm gonna go closer to the mirror just to let you know. It's precise work. Oh my God, darn. By the way, I love those pen. They're actually from Dior because the tip always stay thin and it's like I don't have to constantly like sharpen it. I like it very much. Okay, now that I have the top. Okay. I like it. It's my first time using that color, and I think it has a nice, nice little pink reddish, but not too dramatic. What do you think? Yeah. I like it. So, I know I start small and then I keep like, I keep rising it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like that. Okay, now I'm gonna bring the color in. Into the corner. Okay. Same thing on top. Beautiful. And then I like to do my maximizer. Take it to the center and then spread it out to the side. And same thing on top. And I realize that I have one side is a little higher than the other one. Ah ha ha. Much, much better. Should I powder it? Should I just like, just a tiny bit of powder. And I like to powder it with that micro glitter because like that, it gives even more shine to my lips. Ah, yes. I like that very much. Boom. What do we think? Fabulous. We have 10 minutes before the beginning of the show. And well, even though I look fantastic now, I still need to get dressed. And well, I'm not sharing that with you. So I'm going to turn off my camera. But if you want, we can stay together and I can keep talking while I'm getting dressed. Don't worry. I'll be right back at 6:30 for the show for Quarantine Cabaret at 6:30 tonight. We have a wonderful show and I can't wait to see you there. See you soon, guys. 10 minutes. 10 minutes.
la 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 la. I'm assuming you can still hear me, so.
Thank you.
Oh, guys. It is time for Quarantine the Cabaret. Hi, guys. My name is Billy Boy, and I am here just for you. That's true, though. Just for you, I'm your host tonight for Quarantine Cabaret. Thank you so much for inviting me into your home. I know I'm on your TV right now, but it's like we're together. I'm alone, but I'm not, because you're here with me, and I'm so excited. Quarantine Cabaret Circus at Home by SANCA. I am so excited. Before we start, I have a little something to tell you. I have a little confession. What's happening right now is we are live on YouTube, and somehow YouTube has some copyright for some music, and some of our performers may or may not have some music that might turn us off. In case this live stream is being turned off, do not worry, I'm not going anywhere. I'm still yours for the evening. And so, what do? We go back to the main page of SANCA on YouTube, and we'll start the live right back where we left off. You are not missing anything, I promise. I'll be there right back as soon as we can, if we get pushed out of the of our own life, okay? Go back to SANCA YouTube page and log back in. I will be there waiting for you. That being said, it is time to start. Tonight we have a wonderful show. So many acts, and acts you've never seen before, and acts that have been created just for you tonight. All the acts are performances that our performer put together exclusively for you tonight. How? With the skills they actually learned and practiced and mastered during this quarantine. Tonight, it's all about celebrating something that is absolutely tragic, that's happening to all of us right now, and how can we turn it into something positive and creative that can bring us all together tonight for Quarantine Cabaret. Why I'm on SANCA and coming back together. As you know, SANCA is reopening slowly but carefully its doors. And I just want to let you know that we're super, super, super excited about this. And that your support during this time, during this quarantine, has been absolutely incredible. I want to thank you, each and every single one of you, for your incredible support to SANCA. And I love you, literally. I love you. You make it possible for us to continue our beautiful work at SANCA. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. You are fantastic. You can still donate if you wish on SANCA's website. There is a button at the very top that says "Give to SANCA." And you click on it and you can make a donation. Isn't it easy and perfect and fantastic? And keep supporting SANCA and everything they do. I want to bring to the screen a very important person to SANCA, but also a dear friend of mine. We haven't known each other for very long, but we have a great connection. And he's here! This is John Tanous, the executive director of SANCA, and something more important, my friend. I love you, John. I haven't seen you in a while. What?
Hi, Billy Boy. Really, really glad to be on the call and on this live stream with you tonight. Really excited to see what all of our SANCA students and performers have come up with for tonight.
You are not gonna be disappointed. I picked a little bit. I watched a few videos. Ah, I'm so excited. And yes, I cried a little bit. So my mascara might be running.
Just saying.
I might also cry tonight. We'll see how it goes. So what I wanted to do for tonight, if you don't mind, Billy, I kind of want to jump in and address something important. Are you okay with that?
I was hoping you would do, actually.
Great. So, as you know, right now, there's a lot going on in our world, not just COVID and the coronavirus, but what is happening right now in terms of the protests and racism in our country has really taken a major turn and picked up a lot of momentum in the last couple of weeks. And we felt it would be appropriate to give a little bit of a statement from our community about that. So I'm actually gonna bring onto the call and introduce Manjeet Golden, who is the co-chair of our diversity, equity, and inclusion team that is working specifically on anti-racism at SANCA right now. Hi, Manjeet.
Hey, John. Hey, Billy.
You look so beautiful. I haven't seen you in so long. I'm sorry, everyone. I know we're here for something very important, but girl, you're beautiful.
Thanks, Billy boy.
How are you doing?
You know what? I am doing as well as anyone could under the current circumstances we're all living under. Whew. All right, well, I will just get started. As John introduced me, my name is Manjeet Golden. I co-chair our diversity, equity, and inclusion team alongside of Tanya Nambo Escobar. And I just wrote a little statement for us today. About a week and a half ago, JT sent out an email to our community regarding the recent incident involving the loss of George Floyd to police violence and addressing SANCA's willingness to help support the Black community during this time. As many of you know, last week I spoke at our all staff meeting on the issue with my perspective as a Black woman. At this point, we've been pretty saturated with what's going on in the world, so I don't feel like it's super necessary for me to reiterate any of that. On Wednesday, the DEI, Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion team met to discuss ways how SANCA can actively support the Black community and to begin doing meaningful anti-racist work. Trevor, one of our team members, actually came up with the framework that we are using as well as our theme that we will be operating under with this anti-racist work. In the current movement, aside from hearing Black Lives Matter, we are also being told that this is the time to amplify Black voices. Before we had our last meeting, we asked the team, how do we do this? How do we amplify Black voices? And we come to the conclusion that we do this by quieting white noise. So first I'd like to present a definition of white noise by the Merriam-Webster Dictionary. So the first one is a heterogeneous mixture of sound waves extending over a wide frequency range. The other one is a constant background noise, especially one that drowns out other sounds. So it's really important to me as a member of both the Black community and the SANCA community that this organization do more than make empty promises, make vague statements, and vow to support the Black community. So often marginalized peoples find themselves being placated by eloquent statements of solidarity with zero action. Our DEI team has created a four-step plan in hopes of merely just beginning the long and arduous journey towards being an anti-racist institution. And for full transparency, I was reminded today that although this plan is very established on paper, it has not been approved yet through our community. So I wanted to keep that in mind as I introduce this. So for step one, we would like to establish a shared vocabulary to be used throughout our community. This shared vocabulary would seek specificity in avoiding generalizations and blanket statements, include working understandings of the following interlocking systems of dominations on individual, society, and political scales. So that includes white body supremacy, capitalism, and heteropatriarchy. This vocabulary would also define and clarify terms such as transparency, accountability, diversity, equity, inclusion, intersectionality, and obviously plenty more. So SANCA will be requiring ongoing mandatory DEI trainings, starting with a training that will be developed in-house by our DEI team regarding the use of language. These trainings will be mandatory for all staff, including leadership, as well as the board. We're also currently creating a resource list to go out to our community in case folks are looking for other ways to educate themselves. This list will include books, documentaries, podcasts, and other media, and will mainly focus on Black, Indigenous, queer, and POC content creators. Step two of our plan is white people educating white people. So this one may be the hardest for some of y'all to hear, but I'm gonna ask that you hear me out with this one. So racism has historically been seen as a BIPOC problem and that it's our problem to solve. Well, if we look at how that's worked out 450 years later and here we are, racism is a white problem and it is up to our white allies to educate other white folks. This system of peer-to-peer education also takes some of the emotional labor off the backs of BIPOC folks who, at this point, were tired. Every other Wednesday night, hopefully at 6:30 p.m., Lily will be hosting an anti-racist book club. This book club is in no way limited to white folks only, but the book list and the discussion will be geared towards folks that don't currently have the understanding of what it means to be a BIPOC individual in hopes of creating better allyship in our community. Step three is all about representation, and in that representation, decentralizing whiteness. So we have this kind of split up into three different levels. So out on the floor, which would be, you know, all of the staff and coaches and things. So when SANCA reopens its doors, we hope to have what we're calling a spotlight on our coach wall that will be updated monthly, and it will be used to showcase Black, Indigenous, or POC circus artists, either contemporary or from history. We will also be engaging in what we would like to call a their story instead of a history. Often history is told from the perspective of the white male, and that leads to the erasures of long held Black and Indigenous traditions that have honestly been adapted a lot into modern circus. So upstairs, that includes our leadership. So we are going to try to make steps so that we can have Black, Indigenous, POC folks in leadership, and also upping our recruitment so that we can have those BIPOC folks also on the board as well. And in our communities, you'll be seeing on social media that we will be continuing the Blackout Tuesday. So every Tuesday for the foreseeable future, we will be posting and resharing work from Black artists and community members on social media. We'll be working to support programming that works with marginalized identities, particularly BIPOC folks, and check back in with some of our community partnerships and really assess why we are choosing those. And step four, which I would say is probably one of the most difficult steps and something that I don't think we've done a good job of as an institution, and that is accountability and making sure that we hold ourselves accountable to doing this anti-racist work. So I wanted to obviously make sure that we know that this is the most important out of all four steps. It's easy for an organization to say they are going to do all of these things, but there must be some sort of system of accountability to make sure that it happens. A big part of this accountability is going to be up to leadership and their actions. When employees inform those in leaderships of racist practices, will that employee be heard? Will actions be taken? I would like to say, as an institution, SANCA has been taking the steps to hold itself accountable by creating a team dedicated to diversity, equity, and inclusion that is led by two women of color. It is also up to the community to hold our institution accountable, but also the community itself. Is the Seattle Circus community doing what it needs to do to support BIPOC artists? What about the greater Seattle community? These critical questions must be asked, and people, organizations, and communities must be held accountable. So that is all that I have for the steps that we have come up with. So before I end my little portion, I would like to leave you all with a quote from one of my favorite Black civil rights activists. "Our grandfathers had to run, run, run. My generation's out of breath. We ain't running no more." Stokely Carmichael. On behalf of SANCA, I'd like to say, Black Lives Matter.
Thank you so much, Manjeet. I'm really excited about the DEI team and the work that they're doing under your leadership. I think we have an opportunity with what's happening right now for some serious momentum. And I wanted to very quickly ask you, you know, as a white leader myself, I've been approached by others in the community who have expressed some fear or discomfort about speaking up. And you know, I think we've come up with a term for that, white fragility. Well, not we. I kind of want to push back against it. I think that, you know, people of color face and Black people face deeper and more violent consequences to systemic racism than anything like what this white fragility looks like. So from your perspective, Manjeet, what should we do as white people? Because I think right now is our time to stand up and speak out, not white people's time, I mean everybody's time, to stand up and speak out, to educate one another, and to help turn the tide, because the momentum is building. So more than just educating each other, what actions can we take to help upend systemic racism?
Yeah, I just want to first touch on white fragility, right? Like this idea is that it makes white people feel really uncomfortable to not only talk about race, but to be confronted with their whiteness. And I would just like to, you know, remind or inform some that may not know, but, you know, as a Black woman, I am confronted by my Blackness every day, and it's a very uncomfortable feeling. So it is important that you take some time and you sit in that discomfort. And, you know, I think really educating yourselves, I've been listening to, you know, the book White Fragility on audiobook, and I think that's a great place for people to start if they really want to help confront that. And when it comes to supporting the Black community, I think the biggest thing is that, you know, part of our idea of having the book club of white people educating other white people, a big thing that I've been saying to a lot of my, you know, ally friends is, this is not the time to ask Black people what you need to do, right? Obviously, I'm putting myself forward as the spokesperson for the DEI team, so technically I don't count in this moment, but you really need to look onto your community and look out for you know, information, like the resources are out there. So don't put that emotional labor on your Black friends right now. You know, you can find the information. The hashtag Black Lives Matter has a wealth of information, and a lot of great members of our community are speaking out about the topics at hand.
I really love that. And I want to express to everyone that's watching that this is an uncomfortable moment. And I think it's important for us to be uncomfortable. It needs to be uncomfortable for us to change and grow. We're getting to a point where we've got to jump into the show. This is a conversation that we could probably carry on for quite a while. Manjeet, do you have any last thoughts that you want to share?
Yeah, John, I just have a couple of questions for you. And it's just in regards to accountability. Because I think that's the biggest thing so far. And my questions are, and we can wrap these into one, is how is SANCA as an institution going to hold itself accountable to doing this anti-racist work? And if SANCA decides not to do anti-racist work, how are they going to be transparent about that? And how is the community going to know where we stand as an institution?
Those are great questions. And to really give you a full picture, I mean, I guess the first thing that I would say in terms of accountability is that it's up to all of us. SANCA is not any one person. It's not the board of directors. It's certainly not me. We are all part of this organization. So in terms of accountability, we all have to keep leadership of the organization and myself accountable. I'll be looking to the voices of others. And in terms of transparency, that's a big belief of mine and leadership in general, through all of our operations. So it's important that we communicate things along the way. I don't think, from my perspective, that the organization is gonna not want to do this work. That would be a big struggle for me. I think it's just far too important for us to fully represent and support our community as a whole. So from my perspective, we're absolutely going to do it. And what we need is a really well put together plan that's strategic and long lasting. And so I think in a time like right now, we have, maybe some feeling like we should step up and do something quickly. But I think one of the most important things that we can do is build our DEI team and have somebody like me step out of the way so that other leaders within our organization have a voice about the direction that we're going in. And then through that process, I can be held accountable and the board can be held accountable. We need to make sure that our community has a voice at our board meetings and that they have input about the decisions that we're making and enough time to give us input before those decisions are fully made. You know, so that I'm not stepping forward and just announcing big decisions left and right, but our staff has a chance to know, hey, this is coming up. We want to get your input now. All of that is very, very important, I think, for us to be truly accountable and transparent both to our staff and to our larger community.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, thanks for joining us. Really appreciate you coming. I know that this is, as you mentioned, this is a very, very exhausting time. So I appreciate you stepping up and being here. I know you didn't have to do this, but you did. And I think that's important to me and to our whole community.
Awesome. Thank you so much. And thank you for, giving me a platform to be able to talk about this, because obviously it's a very important issue.
Right.
Thank you so much, Menchi. Thank you so, so much. I really, really, really appreciate the words. And it educates me at the same time. And I think that's what I'm doing a lot right now, educate myself. As you know, I'm not from this country. I didn't grow up here. And I still have so much to learn. And doing what you're doing right now helps me be a better ally, and that's what I want to be, and that's what I know to my core I need to be, and I want to be an ally, but I need to listen to be a good ally. And that's what you're doing right now. You're giving me an opportunity to listen and learn, and I can't thank you enough for that.
Thank you, Billy Boy.
I love you so much.
And I love you too.
And I know, like, this is a hard time, but damn, you look beautiful, girl.
Thanks. I did it for you, girl.
Effortlessly. Effortlessly.
Do you two want me to leave the call?
maybe. But thank you so much.
All right. Bye, thank Billy Boy.
You. Love you. John.
Billy Boy.
John, do you want to give me us a little check-in on what's going on with SANCA right now?
Sure. Yeah. I'm going to keep
happening. I mean, I received your email, so I know there is a lot happening. It's just, like, you know, clarify it a bit.
Sure. And, and this is part of, I guess, transparency, but I'm going to try to keep this brief. I know that we're running pretty deep into the show. So I just want to briefly state that, you know, we've sent out notices. SANCA is hoping that it'll be able to host camps coming up. In the future, probably in July, King County has to enter phase two before camps become possible for us, and camps will be very limited and different than they've been in the past in order to make them safe, socially distant, and help us continue to limit the spread of the COVID virus. And as soon as we get to a point where we're ready to run camps, we will probably also begin to open up our gym for even more activity. Right now, as many people know, we are in modified phase one, which means that we have been able to open up for private lessons and some training. So our gym is starting to see happy people doing circus again, which is such a wonderful feeling. It's been so great to be able to go in and see people back in action in our gym. It's phenomenal. And we're in behind the scenes, we're working our tails off to build a plan for all of this stuff so that our camps run smooth, so that our classes, when we're able to have them again, are all run really well, and that we're doing so with safe social distancing. Circus was not necessarily meant to occur in the midst of a pandemic. So these things might feel a little bit odd at first, but we feel like we can do enough circus that people will be able to get back in the swing of things and have a lot of fun.
I mean, I've been at SANCA the last few weeks, and I've seen so many people cleaning. The cleaning is nonstop right now, and it feels very comforting in a way that I see SANCA taking the right steps to be able to keep everyone safe, and at the same time reopening, because in our mental health, circus is key. I mean, I cannot go on with my day without, you know, doing my thing. So I know how important it is to go back to doing circus, but at the same time, how important it is to do it safely and in an environment that supports the control of the spread of this virus. So I'm so thankful that SANCA is reopening, and I'm so thankful that it's reopening safely. So thank you so much for that effort.
Yeah, it's a pleasure to serve this community. SANCA has so many wonderful people, both students and parents and staff members, everybody, our board and volunteers. It's for me, it's an honor to serve everybody.
Thank you for everything you do, John.
Yeah, thanks, Billy Boy. I hope you have an amazing show.
Oh, it's ready for show. We're about to start Quarantine Cabaret. Guys, beautiful people, ladies and not ladies, we're not going to wait any longer. We're about to start our first act. And I said earlier that actually our show was filled with act that people created just during quarantine, just for you tonight. And I actually laughed. Well, not really. It's just this first act. This one was not made especially for quarantine. It was not made during quarantine, but it's an important piece that I personally really, really love, that I really, really wanted to share with you. So act number one. It's a performance by Acrobatic Conundrum. For the people that don't know Acrobatic Conundrum, look them up. Oh, you ain't for a treat. This act features Katarina Albany, Terry Crane, Melissa Knowles, Xochitl Sosa, Cooper Stanton, and it is created by Terry Crane. This is an act. This act is a callback to a time before quarantine when we could gather and touch. It was fine. It was the finale of the original piece called Fig Tree Belts. In reviewing a bunch of different possible acts to share for the Quarantine Cabaret, Terry chose this because I'm reading his text. Don't judge. I'm just doing my best here. I think it's good to have a reminder of our ability to work together gracefully and creatively. Challenges for me during the quarantine have been staying in touch with purpose while not being able to perform and teach in person. Please welcome to the screen this beautiful act by Terry Crane from Fig Tree Vault's group Trapeze.
Thank you.
beautiful act. Terry Crane is a remarkable, remarkable artist and a remarkable director. And this act was just fantastic. I was telling you earlier about my cat. This is Prince Smooches Clubbo. And he likes makeup, like his mommy. Okay, let's move on to our act number two. Let me introduce you to Amy Olseth Popovic, who's that I actually watched that act because I really like that discipline. Amy is actually doing an act on a globe. And while she was actually practicing, she realized that she doesn't have the right ceiling for it. She couldn't stand on the ball, on the globe, indoor. So she had to do it outdoor and really, really, really enjoy creating this act for you. So this is a globe act that I, Amy, have choreographed during quarantine just for you. Let's go see it. To get outside. If I had a globe, I would be outside every single day. I love it. That act was fantastic. Thank you so much. Our next act. So our next performer, if you haven't seen her at SANCA, you haven't been at SANCA, because she's there all the time, working. She's one of the hardest working performers I know, and I love everything she does, and I can't wait for you to see this new act. And she wrote, despite limited access to gyms, I will keep grinding. This act is made specially for the cabaret in less than a week. I got a poll for World Circus Day
in April, on April 18th. I have the coolest parent. Please welcome to the screen a wonderful artist, Julaine Hall.
From where I'm sat, I learned some dumb and recent facts. But when I'm sad, I turn my head and I clean it out. Man, they call my back, what I could have had if I never gave any to you.
Do not stop. You're fantastic. And second of all, you are right. You have the best parents ever. This is so cool. That setup is incredible. Honestly, I know professional pole artists out there in the world that do not have that setup, that do not have even half of that setup. Your parents are incredible. You're incredibly lucky and you're an amazing artist. Thank you so much for sharing your art with us tonight. Act number four. We are right now, oh, this is such a cute act. I watched it too. I think I might have watched them all. But this is a really adorable, actually, they are all adorable. So this is another incredibly adorable act. Mo and Devon are sisters who are in the youth performance troupe at SANCA. They enjoy spending time together and this act brought them even closer. Please welcome Mo and Devon Helton in Black and White. Doo-doo-doo. Thank you.
what a cute, I love it. I wouldn't change anything about it. The entrance, the ins and out, the dance, love it, guys. You did such a great job. Talking about doing a great job, I'm pretty sure you guys already know, but when you're watching on YouTube, you have the opportunity to leave messages on the chat that is actually on the right to your screen. Feel free to leave as many compliments and as many beautiful things you want to say to our performers. They are watching. They're watching right now on YouTube. Unfortunately, they cannot hear you applause, even though I know you're applauding in your living room right now watching it. So leave them some comments. Tell them how much you love them and how much you love their work and how much you cannot wait to see them live on stage very, very soon, we hope. Our next performer. Act number 5. So this performer is actually a friend of mine. Incredible performer, practice all the time at SANCA, incredible career, has done so many things, so much, to the point that I was actually surprised when she came up with that. I had no idea. I had no idea that it was another of the talent, one of so many already that she has. And now she's coming up with this act and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna retire now. Like, this is it. She's just too good at too many things. So please, welcome to the screen. I'm so excited for you to see that act. Please welcome to the screen, Leslie Rosen in Fire Belly Dancer.
Thank you.
police is not coming to your house, guys. I promise it was in the video. Darn. What a good act. Thank you so much, Leslie. That was fantastic. Leslie is full of talent, so full of surprising talent. Thank you so much. That was like so incredible. And honestly, I kind of want to do it too.
I think I'm going to try tonight.
Act number 6. Oh, that's a beautiful act. It's a bounce juggling act. Caroline has been doing circus at SANCA for nearly 10 years, but just recently began bounce juggling. Bounce juggling is really cool, guys. I can't wait for you to see that. So please welcome to the screen, Caroline Alvaran Bells. Someone that, like you say, like just started, wow, I'm really, really, really impressed, and I'm so excited to see what you're gonna come up in the future in bounce juggling. Thank you so much for sharing with us. Before to introduce you to the next act, I would like to bring to the screen a dear friend of mine. So please welcome to the screen, my dear Molly Barker. Hello! I can't hear you, dear.
Hello, hello.
So good to see you.
So good to see you too. You look so cute. Look at that lipstick. How are you doing, Molly? How are you doing?
Doing well. Yeah.
As good as we can.
Yep.
What have you been doing?
I've been spending a lot of time inside and also trying to spend some time outside.
What do you do though?
What do I do? Well, I get upside down when I can. Some handstands.
Tell me more about getting upside down. How does that work?
I don't know. You just say a little prayer, put your hands down on the ground, hope it all works out.
Put your hands on the ground, put your feet in the air, and pray for success. Okay, I see.
Yeah. I
had the privilege of watching your act before everyone else. And I was very, very impressed and very intrigued. And you put this act for us for this show, and it's very different than what we usually see in circus. There is incredible creation behind it, incredible thought in everything you're doing in this act. And can you tell me a little bit about the creation you did?
Yeah, absolutely. I started working on this act 4 years ago when I was still in college.
You just made me a liar.
I changed it a little bit.
I said you created it just for us. Now you're saying, I started 4 years ago. Okay.
I changed it for you, made it extra special just for you all.
Okay. I like extra special. Okay.
I started working on this act when I was still in college, and I was a dance major in college, but all I wanted to do was get on my hands and do handstands. And my dance teacher kept encouraging me to figure out the purpose behind my handstands and behind being upside down, to like really make a piece where there was a reason for me to be upside down. So I thought a lot about that. I did some writing. And I tried to make a thing.
Finding a purpose to put yourself upside down, that might have been a challenge.
So yeah.
Why do I do that? I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm so excited to present actually this act to our audience. So thank you so much for the creation. Thank you so much for sharing it with us. And would you like to tell us the name of your creation?
The name of my creation is What If.
What If by Molly Bunger. Please enjoy.
What if you turned yourself upside down and knew how it felt to walk on your hands instead of your feet, your brittle wrists confused as to how they got there, unsure of where to go next. Your sturdy tree trunk rooted legs seeking the comfort and pull of gravity, knowing how it feels to fall again and again and again. Wondering how your forearms could ever measure up to your calves, biceps to quads, wondering why, how, and if you can get back on your feet day after day. Your clumsy toes attempting to navigate this dexterous world, feeling out of place. If I can't see you, can you still see me? eyes on hands, eyes on ground, eyes up. Sometimes I forget to look up, but the ground won't disappear. I see feet. I read the calluses written in your skin. Sometimes I forget to breathe. The world looks different.
That was so good. I don't think I'm ready to go upside down. I don't think I can. I don't think my body could. But I really want the same dress to be able to pull it up over my head. I think that's awesome. And I kind of, maybe I should do it with my, look, I can do it with my jacket. Oh, that was so good. Thank you, Molly. And thank you for sharing your process in that creation. That was really, really incredible. Thank you. Act number 8. Oh, that's not awesome. They're all awesome. I'm going to read you a little bit of literature. I'm speaking on behalf of the performer. I chose cigar boxes because I'm not super familiar with them, and I thought it would be a fun challenge and it would force me to work harder to get better. And I've learned that you shouldn't procrastinate while filming, because you have way less time and you end up getting tired and irritated. That act is so good, and knowing that this isn't something you usually do, this is something you just started to force yourself to work harder, just is such an incredible way of looking at it. Thank you so much for sharing with us tonight this beautiful act. So please welcome to the screen an incredible box juggling act by Ava Drummond. Thank you. That was so good. Another great reason to go back outside and juggle. I have to tell you a little story because Eva did it in her act. She dabbed, and I have to admit, I didn't know what the dab was originally, and I thought that was people sneezing in their armpit. Choo! And after that, I got told what it was, and I felt really bad. I felt really stupid. But you know, achoo! Cute and easy. Okay, act number 9. That was a fantastic act too. Oh, I'm so excited for you guys. Okay, inspired by photo challenge as seen on Facebook group Circus Every Day Pandemic, this video features the ultimate strength and beauty of this artist. This act is called Quarantrapeze. Please welcome to your screen, Audrey Spinazzola.
Guys, can we hold up for just 1 second? Here we go! I said, Austin, where are you? Leave right now, and what to do? We know the Northeast is Gotham.
That was so cute. I always wondered how they make this video. I'm going to have to ask. Audrey, a wonderful performance, Quarantrapeze by Audrey Spinazzola and Stephanie Brendler. Thank you so much for sharing your art. This was absolutely awesome. I love that. Okay. Act number 10. This is a juggling and acro act. I'm really excited about it. Let me read you a little something. Juggling together while staying home has been our get up and move breaks while working and schooling from home. Riley has been performing with the Nimbus troupe for the last year and has been in class at SANCA for the last 4 years. Travis has finally started taking classes occasionally himself in the last year. More fun to be active than hang out in the parent watch room. Please welcome to the screen, Juggling and Acro Act by Riley and Travis Boyle.
Thank you.
Oh, that was so cute. Okay, guys, I think I'm coming over. I'm going to have to practice with you. Haven't practiced my jogging in a very long time, and I'm not that good. So I'm coming over. I'm going to practice. I'm going to practice together, especially with that music. I'm like, love it. Love it. I'm going to have to find that song. Act number 11. Oh, that's fun too. They're all fun. What steps are we taking today that may not be useful tomorrow? What things that seem minimal in action that have big impact on others? How do we stay together while apart, mostly in contact through boxes? Movement and stillness are both medicine and provide solace in uncertain time while experiencing intersectional public health and human rights crisis. As We Lay in Wait is a presentation of thoughts and questions in the wild time presented by Coach Christine Denker with musical accompaniment of the peculiar Pretzelman. Please welcome to the screen, my friend, Christine Denker.
Am I coming through?
Good. I loved it. What a great piece. Thank you so much for sharing, Christine. That was fantastic. And honestly, it gives, like, I kind of want to go on tight wire. I haven't done that in a very, 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 I'm not that old, very long time. But that was good. Okay. It's time to take a little break. No, it's not intermission. No, you don't have time to go to the bathroom. It's time to talk to some of my guests. So please welcome to the screen two wonderful, generous members. You're already here. Two generous members of our board of directors. Please welcome to the screen, Beth Baker. Sorry, and Kevin Rudol. Hi, guys. Kevin, where are you?
I seem to be in Assisi in Italy.
You're so lucky. I'm just Hi, Beth. How are you doing? You look fabulous.
Oh, thanks. That gave me an excuse to actually do hair and makeup for a change.
You're ready just for me.
And of course.
Everyone that is watching. Thank you so much for being with us, guys. And thank you so much for everything you do for SANCA. You guys are incredible. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Happy to do it.
Why do you do it? Tell me more. Why SANCA? Why so generous with us?
Well, SANCA is just a wonderful organization. It really does wonders for the community and for the students. It's a real positive contribution to all of society. So it's a pleasure to help.
And you're right, it's true. SANCA does really amazing thing for the community, and the practice of circus does a lot for people and for the world in general. I agree with that. Beth, why do you do it?
I enjoy participating with organizations that are out to do things for the greater good of humanity. And I do believe that SANCA is one of those places with all of the work that we do with our different community outreach partners, and just helping everybody stay fit and active as much as we can these days.
Stay fit. Stay active. Go outside. Stay socially distant, please.
Yes.
So guys, I have a private question to ask. What skill have you been practicing during the quarantine? Circus skills. I don't want to hear about it.
Well, I've been working on a few. I've been on straps. I've been working on my meat hooks. And my leg lifts, and on rope, I've been working on rolling up. So, yeah,
you have a rig at home.
Yeah, 10-foot ceiling.
You're so lucky.
So it's pretty low, but it's way better than nothing. Way better. So I'm not complaining.
Beth, what did you practice?
I haven't been so lucky because I have very low ceilings as well, but I've been working on improving my endurance by just upping my cardio and keeping stretching and flexible as much as I can while we've been stuck at home. So strength and flexibility, a lot of.
That's awesome. I have to say that when I was a performer and traveling, being between contracts, what was the hardest to keep was the endurance. When you have a 6-minute act, individual skills, after a while, you have them. You know, they are not going anywhere. It's like doing bicycle. But the endurance to be able to do all those movement in 6 minutes, that if you don't practice, that doesn't stay. That's not like a bicycle. That goes away. So you're doing the right work right now, working on your endurance, flexibility, and cardio. I'm like, yep, right there. I agree with you. I've been there, done that. I mean, I don't do circus anymore, but that's the right way to do it. That's awesome, guys. That's awesome. I'm so excited to have you back at the school. We're gonna have so much fun. Oh, are you gonna take some private classes when you can?
Yes, I am. I'm already signed up starting next Wednesday.
Already, you were one of the first ones to answer, yes, I want private classes. Absolutely.
As soon as that text message came in, I was like, sign me up.
Love it. Kevin, when are you coming back?
Well, we'll see. I'm officially in a high-risk group. So I'm supposed to stay at home until phase 4, according to the county.
Okay.
Yeah, a long time away, most likely. So we'll see.
You do any of our online classes?
I've been doing some private lessons twice a week via Zoom and Skype.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah.
That's really so good.
Yeah. But yeah, I miss seeing people in person. I have to say that. And I miss being able to do dynamic moves. 10-foot ceiling, you can't do anything dynamic. But
I'm a hugger.
So yeah,
my cat a lot. He doesn't like it that much. But yeah, I'm a hugger. I miss people so much right now. It's not fun.
Yeah,
it's not fun, but it's the right thing to do, though. Staying distant, staying healthy, flattening the curve, and protecting each other. That's very, very, very important. Well, we can't wait to see you back at SANCA as well, and phase 4.
Yeah.
come. It's gonna come. Yeah. Guys, thank you so much for sharing a little bit of your story today. I really appreciate everything you do for SANCA. You guys are incredible, and we wouldn't be able to do what we do without your support. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Billy Boy.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Oh, guys, we're ready for Act 12. You are going to love that one as well. All the acts are just so good. Guys, do you like the show tonight? It's pretty good, huh? Pretty good. Love it. Okay. Are you leaving some comments in the chat? Like I said, because you should. Because the guys deserve it. They work really, really hard on those acts and they are doing fantastic and they deserve your virtual applause. Our next act is really cute. The Shapiro family brings you It's a Wonderful World. Acrobatics are performed by Josephine and Eliana Shapiro, members of SANCA's youth performance troupe, Nimbus and Cirrus Circus. Oh, Nicole and Benjamin Shapiro. Guys, I miss you so much. Collaborated with local musician Josh Rawlings to bring you a modern rendition of this favorite jazz standard. So please welcome to the screen Josie and Eliana Shapiro in What a Wonderful World. Talented family. I loved it. That was so good, Shapiros. Thank you so much for sharing with us. And you're right. What a wonderful world, right? Act number 13. And by the way, I'm just so happy right now because I realized we passed half of our show so far and we haven't been booted out by YouTube. So we're still live. We're still having fun. We're still having a great time in your living room and in my dining room. And I can't thank you enough for being with us tonight. Thank you so much for watching.
Act number 13. A dance following light, love, liberty, and life. And really cool shapes. I hope to bring you out of your trouble for these next 3 minutes and remind you of the love and the magic we all contain. The darker light may seem, the brighter your starlight can shine. So shine without limits. Please welcome to the screen, in an act called Love Can Bring Down the Rain, Gabby Leva! Meow! Mesmerizing. I feel a little bit like a moth on the line. I'm like, oh, that's so cool. That was awesome. Thank you so much for sharing this act with us, Gabby. Thank you so much. That was so beautiful. Act number 14. Fiona has been working on her contortion skills over quarantine to bring you an act inspired by distraction. Distraction. Please welcome to the screen in a contortion act, Fiona Ryan.
Thank you.
Oh, that was awesome. I've never been a contortionist, ever. I'm not bendy. Like, I'm not. But I wish I could. That was incredible, Fiona. Thank you so much for sharing your art with us tonight. That was fantastic. Act number 15. Staying happy and healthy while locked down in the house requires some creative thinking for a circus family. Which circus family am I talking about? I don't know. Wendy, Nick, and Felix put on their thinking caps, literally, to come up with something new for this quarantine circus. Please welcome to the screen beautiful, beautiful artists and incredible circus family. The Harden family, Nick, Wendy, and Felix Harden! Felix is the best. Justin! That was an incredible act, guys. Thank you so much for sharing. Oh, guys, you're here! How are you? How are you guys doing?
We are great. How are you?
Where's Felix? Where's my favorite?
Oh, we had to put him to sleep. He couldn't make it.
I know, it's late. I'm sorry. Yeah. That was such a good act, guys. You guys are fantastic. How is it to be in the middle of a pandemic, performers at home with a kid?
It's been hard.
Yeah.
It's been, Yeah, it's been hard. We've had to be really creative with how to fill our days and not to get too panicky about when we might perform again and when, you know, we'll perform in front of a live audience that's sold out. That feels really far away.
I mean, that's what I was like trying to talk. Like, it's, we're doing shows, like obviously tonight it's a show, but it's very different to be in front of an audience versus recording something that will be seen later. The energy is not the same. Like, even just me, usually on the backstage, like getting ready with everyone. And now I'm like, I'm alone. You know, and I understand like the difficulties of you filming something that is incredibly skilled, but at the same time, without the adrenaline of a live audience. And
yeah.
Yet, you guys did an amazing job. That was a really, really cool act. I really loved that. How long have you been working on that?
Well, we started doing hats actually not too long before quarantine, kind of at the beginning of the year. We started working on it seriously.
Okay. And
it's pretty much all we've been able to train in our house. So that's a slight positive.
Playing in the house?
No.
That was really cool. Like, and now knowing that you started only at the beginning of the year, I'm even more impressed. That was like so cool. And I was about to say a bad word, but I'm not, because I'm so that was really incredible. Thank you so much, guys, for sharing. Thank you so much. You have a beautiful family. Take care. I see you at the school. And I love you.
We love you. Bye, Billy.
Oh, guys, that was awesome. Act number 16. Amy and Iska wanted to make this act to portray the longing to connect that many people feel right now while isolation. That is so cute. It's an acrobatic and tumbling act with Amy and Iska Popovic.
We want.
Oh, that was so good, guys. Oh, what a beautiful ad. Thank you so much for sharing. That was, that really, I might have cried a little bit. But I have mascara on, so I cannot cry for too long. I don't cry, you cry. Act number 17. Days of isolation pass by as I am confined to a box of a room. It's not all that bad though. I have been able to finish that book I started 2 years ago. Stay in my PJs all day and practice what circus skills I can in my apartment. When I fall asleep, I dream of dimensions divine. Though my body rests, my soul rises above the chaos and the city of the city, ascending up above the earth. I found everything I need to have been here within me all along. With the dream power I hold, I transform into a celestial being, dancing along the sky with color and light. This is the happiness of creative freedom, out of the box and into the heavens. Please welcome to the screen, Out of the Box and Into the Heavens by Leila Magnolia. It's the Should I read it again? Do you want me to read it again? Leila is a wonderful artist, guys. And that act honestly was absolutely fantastic when I saw it the first time, and I cannot wait for you to see it. So here it is. Thank you.
What a wonderful performance. Again, I was mesmerized. I think it's the lights. I'm like, ah. Please welcome to the screen to talk to us about her performance, Leila Magnolia. Darling, darling, are you here? Here you are.
Ooh. Hello.
How are you doing, dear?
Doing well. I'm sorry I'm not dressed up as fabulous as everybody else, but this is my authentic quarantine self.
You look fabulous. Those earrings are adorable, by the way.
Thank you. Hold on, I'm gonna turn off my projector because I'm watching you guys all on my big screen.
Look
right
to
now.
Me. Oh, yeah.
Me. It's a little distracting, so I'm just gonna turn it down.
I want you to tell us a little bit about flow art. I've seen it before at concerts and events, but like it's a whole genre. Can you tell us more about it?
Yeah, so hold on just one second. My computer still has the projector running so I can hear me on the live stream video. Okay, there we go. So, sorry, hold on. Technical issues with, and this is a part of the flow state, right? We have to go with the flow and make the best of what we have.
You just fine though.
Okay, for real now. So flow arts is it falls under the umbrella of circus arts. And also it is a tool that I have come to learn is useful in meditation. And so for flow arts, for me, it's when you can get into that flow state of mind of syncing with your object that you are putting your intention into, and you are learning how to manipulate it, and not in a malicious way, but trying to use it as an extension of yourself. And when you start to find different combinations of how your brain works with the mind-body connection, it can unlock a lot of possibilities with something as simple as a piece of plastic like my hula hoops or clubs or like Gabby's staff, LED toys are super useful for it because you get just like, it's geometric divine shapes along with your own authentic expression.
So there is something like it's an art and at the same time, it's almost like a way of living that supports actually like your true self in extension to the world through the object.
Absolutely.
I love it. I'm gonna have to start doing it. I mean, I've been meditating. Meditation has been helping me big time during this quarantine, like big time, because I'm going cray cray. I've never spent that much time with my husband. So I've been meditating and I think I'm gonna have to take on this flow art because meditating has been great. It hasn't been enough.
So also a state of flow mind, flow mindset is that you take what you have and you create from it. So you can find flow arts outside, indoors. Make sure you got enough space so when you're first starting out, because I've broken a couple things. But it's a useful tool to take wherever you go. You can always find me with a hula hoop anywhere I go. And honestly, it doesn't matter if it's for performance or just personal practice. It's something that really centers me when everything else doesn't make sense.
I used to do contact juggling. I always had a ball in my backpack and just like running it through my hands was just so soothing. And I love it, love it. Leila, thank you so much. That was a really remarkable performance. Thank you so much. And thank you for sharing with us your passion. Bye, love you. Oh, guys, act number 18. I'm opening it with you. I made these little cards and I have that little piece opening and folding. I love it. Oh, it's time for another contortion act. That's super exciting. Please enjoy this contortion act brought to you by Maya Bijou, with special thanks to her contortion coach, Gunnar Field, and her stratus coach, Alyssa Hellrong. Please welcome to the screen in a beautiful, adorable contortion act, Maya Bijou. That was adorable, and what a great way to use a coffee table. Ah, love it. That was a beautiful song as well. Love, love this act. Thank you so much, Maya. Our next performer says, and I translate. It's hard to be stuck at home with no access to circus classes. It's even harder to be stuck at home when you can't reach anything. Rawr. Please welcome to the stage a T-Rex in short arm blues. Thank you.
Guys, don't be scared. That wasn't a real T-Rex, I promise. That wasn't his home! What a wonderful act. Thank you, thank you. That was awesome. Thank you so much, Amy. I know you guys, if you've been to SAS before, Amy has presented a version of this act already live, but reworked it completely and took it to a new level with this performance. Thank you so much. I really appreciate you, Amy. And also, Amy is working behind the scene right now to make this beautiful show happen. By the way, I would like to thank a ton of people right now. John, Jeff, Mila, Amy, and everyone behind this performance that made this possible, and all the beautiful artists. Act number 20. Molly and Laura have been going crazy in quarantine together in their apartment for over 2 months. This is the act they made as a creative outlet and to explore what it might be like to be a struggling flower in a garden. Please welcome to the screen Photosynthesis by Laura Sposato and Molly Barger. Woo-hoo!
Oh, I really wanted that thing. I just want to sing. I love you, baby. Won't you bring all the flowers you find out in the garden? Don't tell me the truth that your heart has hardened. But you don't want me anymore. How can it be? Look what you've done to me.
Be a pretty flower too. Next time guys, you have to invite me to have a wonder in the garden. That was so cool. Thank you so much for sharing, guys. Thank you. Last but not least, I know it's our last act of the evening. I know. But it's a good one too. Guys, it's a big one. I introduce to you Waiko Zoomers with Alyssa Hellrong, Ryan Mary Aiken, Morrison Hilton, Valerie Karimsakov, Zyla Butcher, Riley Boyle, Devin Hilton, Leah Noble, Yona Pionko, Amy Popovic, Aliana Shapiro, Maya Bijou, Amaranta Sizemore, and Maya Townsend. Zoom is for more than just boring meetings, everyone. Please enjoy the antique of Coach Alyssa and the members of Cirrus, Nimbus, and Stratus Circus. Please welcome to the screen, the Wyco Zoomers. That was so cute. I miss you too, guys. I miss you so much. Are you gonna make me cry? But that's okay, because it was the last act of the show and I can cry now because you won't see me with my raccoon eyes. Guys, it was the last act. But that was such a great evening. Thank you so, so much for being with us tonight. Thank you so much for everything you do for SANCA. Thank you to every single performer tonight. You guys have been absolutely amazing. I love you all. Thank you for the time. Thank you for your energy. Thank you for your art and thank you for your love. I cannot thank you enough. Guys, before I go, I miss you. I miss you all so much. And I can't wait to see you again at SANCA. I want you to be safe. I want you to take care of yourself and I want you to love yourself and love the people around you. Keep spreading the love, keep spreading Circus, and we'll see you soon, guys. I love you. Have a wonderful night. Bye.